for yoga. Have you decided about the yoga program, whether you do it or not? Or you are unable to decide? you can spare one weekend. You always enjoy your weekend. You will be enjoying your weekend.
We are just only one.
Yes, you have got only one weekend. So better spend it here.
Spend
we
are
it.
Just
practicing
yoga
in
the morning.
Yes, and you see, and this yoga is really very good. It's really very good. Particularly when you see now you have reached such a stage of your life and your career, it's so much stressful, and at the same time physically we are not in our best form. Physically wearing out. On the contrary, stress is increasing. That's why managing stress. So anyway, you know, I have recently joined here. It's not yet completed 6 months. Before joining here, immediately before joining here, I attended a training program at Harvard University. It's a refugee resolution program. Ministry of Public Administration has arranged for secretaries. My topic was on managing change. And in that program, I found one topic very interesting, at least for me. And I thought that it would be a good takeaway. And I have actually adopted, and I'm taking this session in all of my courses here in BPATC. And this is Know Thyself. Know Thyself is very common. You may have heard many times, but this focus is on understanding self to achieve improvement goals. Understanding self to achieve improvement goals. So, you see, all of us have shortcomings. No one is perfect. So, everybody has a scope to improve. Now, sometimes we can't improve ourselves. Particularly, we don't want to improve ourselves. We want to change ourselves. We want to change the world. We want to change everyone around us, but we don't want to change ourselves. And sometimes most of the time, not sometimes, we don't look inside us, who I am, how I am operated, what motivates me, and what demotivates me. What are my constraints?
We
do not want to dig deep or say dark. So in this session, the focus is on yourself. So myself, and this is actually based on a Harvard publication called "Immunity to Change" by Robert Keegan and Lisa Lane. And originally, the session was developed by Timothy O'Brien, who is a lecturer at Harvard University. So I have further adapted it to our circumstances. It's not the original one, just to make it suitable for our context. So I have So you see, many a time in Western culture, they have a culture of making annual resolution, particularly on New Year's Eve, that this year I will do this, or I won't do this, I will improve myself. do not have such ritualized annual resolution system, but we also do this, say, maybe on our birthday, maybe on our anniversary day, we commit ourselves that I must improve, or I should not do this, or I should do that, etc. But you may find that you are unable to achieve that, and you are making the same commitment to yourself year after year without any success. There are some examples. There are some examples here. You see that examples of New Year's resolution starting from 9 to 12. 12 is the year of publication of the book. So lose weight, lose more weight, lose weight again. Get fit, unable to get fit next year. Then give up alcohol and cigarettes, or unable to give up, drink less. Stand up to boss. Boss is very abusive, so you you think that you can't cover it any longer, so I must stand up to the boss, I must protest. But soon you realize that you have to change your job, look for a new job. In our case, look for another push test. Yes. Then try to be nicer. Be nicer to my wife. Then try to be nicer to my wife. Then by this time wife has left. So try to be nicer to my ex-wife. Then sort of jump in life. Jump in shape, jump in life. So all of us pile up many jumps around our office. I usually do, and also at our home, and also in our life, we carry many junks. So, shedding some junks, we try, but we are not. So, year after year, 9, then 10, then 11, then 12, another thing. So, why these problems are so sticky? Why we are unable to improve? So we will try to understand the dynamics. What causing this status quo? Why we are unable to change? And we will go step by step. I will let you go through an example. And you will be working on yourself. You will be working on yourself. Okay. So I will first give you the example, and then you will do it yourself. This way we will proceed. Now there are some examples here. It's a quotation from Dr. Edward Miller, who is the CEO of Johns Hopkins University Medical Center. It's like that 90% coronary artery bypass grafting patients do not change their lifestyle. They know very well that they have to change their lifestyle, they have to change their eating habits, but they don't. They carry on their lifestyle and try to depend on medication, but do not want to change their lifestyle. So most people are like that. Now, I will give you an example of a Gordon. He's a real life person. He's a popular guy. He's a chain smoker. He has gained weight, which is not appropriate for a military officer. He's a hypertension patient. He has got coronary artery disease. Doctor and his family placing him to quit smoking. He's a chain smoker. So this is his problem. So he has tried several times to quit smoking, but unable to quit smoking. It happens to many people that quitting smoking is difficult. So we will examine his case. Why he is unable to quit smoking? And how he should proceed quit smoking?
Addiction to drugs is that I'm not smoking drugs. Smoking is such a bad habit that hardly a people can quit it, but all other habits they can quit. Smoking is more powerful than other drugs.
Yes, but still people can quit. It's not impossible to quit. It's not impossible to quit. People can. But you need strong determination. You need strong efforts. And you need concerted efforts. So anyway, we will examine his case thoroughly. Okay. So before going into his case, we will look into your personalities, okay? Each of you. So, you have been given a pieces of paper. Yes. So, in the first page, in the box, identify three personal problems. Personal problems should be important problems which is affecting your personal life, family life, or social life, or professional life, whatever. These problems are significant problems, and you must do something about it. And how do you know that these are very important problems? I'm talking about behavior problems, and it is own behavior. It's your behavior. Okay. So how do you behavior problem. Not disease or anything. It's behavior problem. Okay? Sorry? Yes, this is a behavioral problem. If you are a compulsive eater, you must eat something. So it's a behavioral problem. So behavioral problems are significant. Behavioral problems are those problems when you get complaints about your behavior. That your spouse is complaining against you, your children are complaining against you, your siblings or your parents are complaining against you, or your boss is complaining against you, or your subordinates and colleagues complaining against you. So in this way you know that you are causing problem. Many people have many behavioral problems. In this way you will identify your personal problems. But we will be sharing this problem with everybody. So do not write very intimate problem, okay? So the problem which cannot be shared with, So there are intimate behavioral problems which cannot be shared with others. So we are not looking at very personal problems which cannot be shared. So identify those problems which are significant at the same time, which can be shared with your colleagues. Okay? So identify three problems. Right in the box. Yes, in the box. In the box.
First page.
Inside the box. Think about first. I'll give you 5 minutes time. 5 minutes time.
ছিল বস 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 ছিল ছিল না তো
Your task is, attention please, your task is identify the most important one. Out of three, you will select one. Okay, both of you will identify the most important one. Out of three for individual. Okay, out of three, you identify the most important one in consultation with your partner. Okay, partner will ask questions. So why it is important? Okay.
Looking the glass,
say Bizarre will always say that this glass is half empty. Rather than looking or describing the glass as half empty, describing it as a half full. Half full, not half empty. So so he will try to be positive. Yes, optimistic and positive. So that's his improvement goal. That's his improvement goal. And this visa, his improvement goal will be to diversify his food habit, not depending on rice only. And for her, this is to open up. She is probably shy also, or doesn't feel comfortable in speaking. So, in this way, the rest of you, you please set your improvement goals. What you want to improve it based on your number one problem. Okay, based on your number one problem, set your improvement goals. So, three of you is already done. So, rest of you, please set your improvement goals. Okay. Yes. You write it down on the second page first. Second page. We will go to the third page later. This is the second one. Yes. But this is the third one, not that one. Firstly, we will concentrate on the second page. Set your improvement goals and answer to the questions. This is, go to the second page. This is not the second page. This is the second page. So again, 5 minutes time.
What actions you have taken? Not to eat guys.
Have you tried it? So, what is this?
I have tried it only in breakfast.
Only in breakfast?
Yeah,
okay. Okay. So, you eat rice three times a day. So, you try in breakfast. It's a good approach to start with. Step by step. So, how long did you? So, what did you eat instead of rice? Yes. When you attempted, to change routine. You have stopped that. So, routine vegetables. You have stopped eating routine vegetables after a few days. Oh, you are continuing. So you were successful in the breakfast form. So you have been successful for the breakfast. But now you have to do it for lunch and your dinner. So you are moving ahead. Good. Okay. Sit down. And have you made any efforts? Children.
Some positive states, say Nizam has
bread in his breakfast instead of rice. So Zafreen has attempted how he is speaking with her children. So these are some steps, effective or not. These are positive steps towards achievement of their improvement goals. In column 2, we are basically talking about negative actions and inactions. Say, for the colonel, his negative actions. Okay, colonel has got some positive actions. Colonel's positive actions are basically, he has decided that he will not buy any cigarettes. He has stopped and he is holding on. He is not paying any money for cigarettes. So this is his positive step. And his other positive step is that he has decided not to smoke at home. He will not smoke at home and he is holding on. So two positive steps. He is not buying with his own money and he is not smoking at home. So these are two positive steps, but at the same time he has some negative steps. He is continuing with his negative steps. Negative actions are, I accept offer of smoking from my boss. His boss is a smoker and whenever boss offers him a cigarette, he gladly accepts. And not only that, I accept offer of smoking from my subordinates. Subordinate knows that the boss starts smoking, they offer him cigarette and he gladly accepts. And he plays card and visits the room of officer's mess where everyone smokes. And I accept offer of smoking from my mess card room mates. So he's a card player and he goes to officer's mess every day, he visits a card room where everyone smokes, and whenever he goes there, everyone offers him cigarette and he gladly accepts it. So although he is not buying cigarette and not paying for cigarette, but he has got plenty of opportunity of smoking because of his negative actions. And inactions are, I am not saying no to offer of cigarettes. He is not saying no. Whenever somebody offers him, he says yes. And I am not stopping visiting card rooms of officers. So if he stops visiting card room, that will reduce his smoking. And I am not visiting billiard room in the officer's mess. There's a billiard room and where no one smokes. But he doesn't visit the billiard room. He goes to the card room. So actually he is looking after opportunity to smoke. Although his declared goal is quit smoking. So because of these negative actions and inactions, he is unable to quit smoking, although he has made some positive steps. So these are counterproductive actions and inactions. So in column 2, you will be now identifying your negative actions and inactions. What negative actions or what inactions you are taking because of which you are unable to achieve your declared improvement. So this is in column 2. Negative actions or inaction that you should do but you are not doing.
Any serious issues? Have you made any serious issues? Any systematic issues?
there's the issue. Now, if you try it, then what's the result? What do you think about? So, these are the questions asked here. Now, say, if you can go in up to STEM, now, this is why this goal is important. This is important to perform. What do you think?
Perform easily.
To perform easily with other sectors. To get support of other people.
Subject.
What PPS actions have you made to make this change? I promise not to lose time now. This is not action. This is just a promise. This is just and I forget the problems that so actually you didn't take any action. you didn't take any action. So we are talking about action. What actions you have? What actions you have? Now for these are masters. What actions you have taken? Not to you guys. Have you tried it? So what is this? Only breakfast. Okay. So you eat rice three times a week. So you try to eat breakfast. So good approach. Start step by step. So how long did you? So what did you eat instead of rice? Yes. When you attempted to change. You have stopped that. So rooty and vegetables, you have stopped eating rooty and vegetables after a few days. Oh, you are continuing. So you were successful in the breakfast form. So you have been successful for the breakfast. But now you have to do it for lunch and your dinner. So you are moving ahead, good. Okay. Sit down. And have you made any efforts? Children. Thank you. Only one code, important one. So, I'm going to take out. Just copy the improvement code into the power one, then gradually we will move to other ones. Now, look at the case of our body. His improvement goal is to quit smoking once and for all. He has made several attempts to quit smoking, and initially he was successful, but after some time he resumed smoking again. So his improvement goal is quit smoking. So this is aim to quit smoking finally. Improvement goal we have already discussed. It should be a strong goal, it's true for you, implicates you, and there really is room for improvement. It is significantly related to your life. It is important to you for a 5 scale of 1 to 5. So in this way, we will identify the improvement. So you have worked here. Finding your focus, we have already done this. Now starts next phase, column 2. Doing and not doing. Doing and not doing means negative. Negative doing and not doing. You see, you have already identified in phase 2 some positive steps. Say, Nizam has introduced bread in his breakfast instead of rice. So, Zafreen has attempted half speaking with her children. So, these are some steps, positive, effective or not. These are positive steps towards achievement of their improvement goals. But in column 2, we are basically talking about negative actions and inactions. Say, for the colonel, his negative actions. Okay, colonel has got some positive actions. Colonel's positive actions are basically, he has decided that he will not buy any cigarette. He has stopped and he is holding on. He is not paying any money for cigarette. So this is a positive step. And his other positive step is that he has decided not to smoke at home. He will not smoke at home and he is holding on. So two positive steps. He is not buying with his own money and he is not smoking at home. So these are two positive steps. But at the same time, he has some negative steps. He is continuing with his negative steps. Negative actions are, I accept offer of smoking from my boss. His boss is a smoker, and whenever boss offers a cigarette, he gladly accepts. And not only that, I accept offer of smoking from my subordinates. Subordinate knows that the boss asks smoking, they offer him cigarette, and he gladly accepts. And he plays card and visits the room of officers' mess where everyone smokes. And I accept offer of smoking from my mess card room mates. So he's a card player and he goes to officer's mess every day, visits a card room where everyone smokes, and whenever he goes there, everyone offers him cigarette and he gladly accepts it. So although he is not buying cigarette and not paying for cigarette, but he has got plenty of opportunity of smoking because of his negative actions. And inactions are, I am not saying no to offer of cigarettes. He is not saying no. Whenever somebody offers him, he says yes. And I am not stopping visit to card rooms of officers. So if he stops visiting card room, that will reduce his smoking. And I am not visiting billiard room in the officer's mess. There's a billiard room and where no one smokes. But he doesn't is in the beard. He goes to the front. So actually he is looking after opportunity to smoke. Although his declared goal is quit smoking. So because of these negative actions and inactions, he is unable to quit smoking, although he has made some positive steps. So these are counterproductive actions and inactions. So in column 2, you will be now identify your negative actions and inactions. What negative actions or what inactions you are taking because of which you are unable to achieve your declared improvement. So this is in column 2. Negative actions or inaction that you should do but you are not doing. You will be sharing with each other your actions and inactions.
Thank you. If you try to do, you're
not going to. your case will be like our rural development secretary. So it's better not try those things. Make the traffic. You see, traffic jam, this is a question. So you can't do much about this. So what you can do is no traffic. Yes. It's a one day in my, but you can't do it. You, when I say constant, that means you can't do anything about it. One day traffic will be less, another day traffic will be more. You can't help yourself. This is beyond your control. So then, in order to become path to work, what you need to do is to start out. That's the key. Now, start earlier, saying it easy, but it's not that easy, starting earlier. If you want to start earlier, there are certain factors. So, you see, particularly for our female colleagues, that it might be the case that you have to prepare breakfast for the family. So, you have to see of your spouse, you have to see of your children, going to schools, etc. There might be those issues, other factors. And also, if you don't have such problem, even then, you see, you have to change your lifestyle. You have to go to bed early. If you go to bed late, then you cannot get up early in the morning. So it's a change of lifestyle. So you may have developed a habit of watching TV, movie, TV serials, late night talk show, etc. So you have to stop doing that if you want to go to bed early. You see, it's a chain. It's a chain of actions. So one is attached to another one. So if you can change your habit, then you can go to bed early, you can get up early, then you can start early. And if you start early, particularly say from Uttara, you will get less traffic if you start at 7. If you start after 7, it's an unknown journey. So you don't know when you will reach secondary. So you must make sure that you start before 7. If you start before 7, then you won't be late. So you see, Shamima, so how you need to articulate your problem. And you were thinking that distance is the problem. Actually, distance is not the problem. It might be the case, even if you reside at Iskandar, you even then you might be late.
And even some people coming from Uttara on right way.
Yes. It depends when you start, when you get up from bed, when you go to bed, etc. So these are the factors. Then take Afreen's case. She has also not identified her problem properly. So I'm discussing it for everyone's learning. How we should understand our problem, how we should analyze our problems. If we don't understand the problem, then we cannot solve our problem. Okay? So you see, Afreen's problem is, identifying problem is, she is tense. She is always tense. So, she has identified negative actions as she thinks about an issue all the time. It's in her head, always. She is thinking about the problem. Now, that's why she is always tense. She is tense at office and she is tense at home. She is always tense. Now, if we analyze her problem, that why she is so tense? Why she cannot remove the tension? You see, so analyzing will lead us that she is not confident. She is not confident. So why she is, then the next question is, why she is not confident? Why she is not confident? If you are confident that I know what to do, I know how to do, I know what to tell my boss, I know boss will not get any opportunity to find any fault with me, and if boss finds any fault with me, I'll be able to defend myself, then you won't be intense. Now, how you can reach that level? In order to reach that level, you need to have adequate knowledge, adequate information, adequate data of a particular problem. Okay? So, whenever a problem comes at your hand and you have to provide solution, then you have to put in efforts in understanding the problem. What's causing it? And what are the options, alternate options? And amongst the alternate options, which option is most suitable? And prepare yourself accordingly, that you will convince your secretary that this is the problem, this is the reason, this is the solution. And you may come up with alternate solution. So if you don't agree with this one, you can go for this plan B, solution B. So, if you can do that, you won't feel tense any longer. But probably you are unsure about the problem itself, you are less prepared, and you are not confident what to write, what to propose, and how to defend it if boss doesn't agree with you. What to do? So you are unsure. So that's why you are tense. Now, there's more dimensions in it. That there's competition. There's competition. If there was no competition, you would not have been so much tense. That failure will cost you. Failure will cost your position. Failure will cost your status. Failure will cost your promotion. So you are concerned about those things. That you are thinking that if you are unable to provide a good proposal to secretary, finance secretary, who happens to be a SSB member, you won't get next promotion. Okay? So you are always scared. You are always scared. But you see, these are actually assumptions. That you think that if you don't, what you are doing, this is not enough. Boss might be unhappy with me, or if I fail the boss, this will have very negative consequences, and it will doom my career. I might get importance. I might lose attention of the boss or status inside the ministry. I may be sidelined. I may not get a foreign trip. So many things can happen. So you are assuming these things. Because you are assuming these things, you are feeling tense all the time. Okay? So, your assumptions might be true, but might not be true. Might not be true. So, what you are assuming, your boss may not be thinking like that. He might be very happy with you, but you are unsure about this. So whether your assumptions are true or not, you have to test it. So that's our next issue. Worry box. You see, column 3 is worry. We are worried. Many people have identified the problem of losing temper. You are worried. You are worried about something. Say, we have got compulsive rice eater, and we have got compulsive rich food eater. So, Mahyu is fond of eating rich food. So, you see, everybody is worried about something. So in our Cornell's case, what actions and inactions he are taking, if he refused offer of smoking from his colleagues and peers, stopped visiting card room, and the officers has started visiting billiard on his team, he is worried that he would be disliked by his colleagues and peers. He would have no friends, he would have no recreations. So these are his worries. Why he accepts offer of cigarettes from everybody? Because he is worried that if he doesn't accept offer of cigarettes, that he might be disliked by his boss, his colleagues, his subordinates, and he would have no friends. And also he would have no recreation. He thinks that this is his recreation. And that's why actually he is behaving like this, because of these worries. And based on these worries, we have got a hidden competing goal. The declared goal is quit smoking, but hidden competing goal is different. Say, Zafrin is shy of public speaking. Why she is shy of public speaking? Why she is not taking up opportunity to speak publicly? She might be worried that she will look stupid when she speaks. This is her worry. And she is committed to not looking stupid. She wants to be look like a very competent professional. And she thinks that she is worried that if she go to the podium and start talking, people might think that she doesn't know anything. Her English is not good, her pronunciation is not good, her knowledge is not enough. People may start thinking, how this lady has become an additional secretary. So these might be her worries. And because of these worries, she won't, you know, take up any opportunity to speak publicly. So whenever an opportunity comes, she will shy away. She will never volunteer because of her worries. So based on our worries, we develop our hidden competing goal. Like, if I worry, I will look stupid, I'll be committed to not looking stupid. And if I worry, I will disappoint someone, I am committed to not disappointing people. Like eating, like Mohyul likes eating rich food, fast food, etc. So he thinks that this is his entertainment. He loves eating, and this is his entertainment. Eating is entertainment. And if he stop eating, he might be worried that he won't have any entertainment. What's the meaning of life if I don't eat a burger? Okay, so This kind of thinking, this kind of worries. So every people, say for Vizal might be worried that there's no meaning in life if I don't eat rice. So I have to eat rice. So it has become a kind of eating rice has become a kind of passion. It's kind of entertainment. It's not requirement of the body, it's requirement of mind. Because body requirement is calorie. And you can get calorie from any other food stuff. Body will be happy, but your mind won't be happy. And mind is also important. You cannot ignore requirement of mind. So that's why you are continuing with your having. And you see, this hidden, this flow from your fear, your hidden competing goals flow from your fear. These are commitments to self-protection. Say, Afrinsky, she's tense. She's afraid of something. She's scared of something. So out of her fear, she is protecting herself. And with a certain kind of behavior. And anger, many people have, identified anger or losing temper. This is also same. You are worried about something. What is worry? Why you lose temper? Because you want to deliver fast. You want to deliver accurately. So, you are worried if you don't deliver fast, if you don't deliver quickly, if you don't deliver accurately, then it will have very negative consequences for you. So, boss will be unhappy with you, you will be adjudged as an inefficient officer. You may lose many opportunities involving your desk. Or even you may get transferred, you may be rejected during promotion, you may not become a secretary. So there are so many things to be worried about. So because of those worries, you have developed a hidden competing goal that I must deliver accurately and firstly. And whoever is standing in front of me and creating obstacle, I must demolish him or not. And you burst out. Okay. So these flow from your fear. These are commitment to self-protection. These are not noble, can feel embarrassed. Okay. So in the Cornell's case, because I worry I have been rejected by my colleagues and peers, I am committed to not be rejected by my colleagues and peers. So in this way we write a hidden competing goals. Okay? Now you can write down your worry box and your hidden competing goal. Okay? So write it down. 5 minutes time. So I have discussed some of yours. I have discussed already some of yours. Those who have not yet covered, you identify your worries. What you are worried about? And what is your hidden competing goal based on the worry? So for Cornell's case, I worry, I would be disliked by my colleagues and peers, I will have no friends, I will have no regret. So I am committed to not being rejected by my colleagues and peers. So this is his hidden competing goal. 5 minutes time. you can discuss with your partner. You discuss.
Hidden
competing goals, out of a worry, out of a worry that if you don't behave this way, people will think of you just like other people. So you won't have a different status. You will have the same status of other people's and colleagues who doesn't see anything. So you don't want to be like that. So you want to differentiate yourself from others. You want to be in a higher place or a separate place from the rest. So this might be your hidden competing goals. And because of these hidden competing goals, you are behaving the way you are behaving. Okay, that in this way you impress other people. So so you are worried if you don't behave this way, then people won't be impressed by you. People may ignore you. People may not judge you appropriately. So based on these assumptions and hidden competing goals, you are behaving the way you are behaving. Now, you see, so in this way, our actual behavior is contradictory to our declared objective. Declared objective. Now, our big assumptions might be true or may not be true. The world may or may not actually be in this way. So, the assumptions you are making might be true, might not be true. Now, in order to improve yourself, you need to test your assumptions. So, whether my assumption is true, say for Vizan's case, that are really people impressed by you because you identify faults with everything, or actually it's going in the opposite direction, that people are thinking of you negatively, that this man hasn't really managed to find faults with everything. So, so you need to test your assumption. And also, I think case that you are tense because of your assumptions that your boss or your colleagues may think that you are not good enough for the status and privilege you are enjoying in finance industry. So this might be your assumption, and because of these assumptions you are behaving the way you are behaving, you are always tense. So so your assumptions might be true, your assumptions might not be true. So you need to test your assumptions and start with a smaller step. Like our this Mizan, he has started with breakfast, started replacing rice during breakfast. It's a one step. It's a one step. Have you been successfully doing this?
Yes.
Not eating any roti in any rice in addition to roti?
Sometimes in rainy day I
eat roti. Okay. No, sometimes it's okay if it is. But we always eat khichdi on rainy days with shorsha in it. Okay, it's occasionally it's good, but if you do it regularly, then it's not good. Okay, so this is first step. So in this way, we will test our assumptions. So this is now testing the assumption. A good test is a smart. Smart means safe, modest, actionable, research-oriented, test your story. So this is smart. So for the corner case, I'm not going to reject offer of cigarettes from my boss because this is risky. So so if boss becomes unhappy, yes, it may have serious consequences. But I will regret the offer from my staff officer. He's a commanding officer, she has a staff officer. So he can start with his staff officer. That if he, what happens if he regrets an offer from his staff officer? So this is his smart test. So, smart test data, result of the testing. That was fine, it took 5 seconds, it's over with. I didn't like it, but I don't think my staff officer has stopped liking me. So, his assumption was that if he doesn't accept offer of cigarette, people will be unhappy with him. They won't, they will dislike him. So, he has regretted offer of cigarettes from staff officer, and it appears that staff officer is not unhappy. So, in this way, he can then reject offer of cigarette from his colleagues, then from friends, and finally from his boss, gradually gaining strength to say no. And also he may stop visiting the guard room of officer's mess. He may start visiting billiard room. Instead of playing cards, he may start playing billiard, or he may start playing golf. They have all the opportunities. Now, playing card cannot be the only recreation. There are many other recreations, like eating rice or eating fast food cannot be the only recreation. There are so many recreations. So, explore alternatives. Explore alternatives. So yes, in this way, start with a simple one, and gradually expand it, and you may find that your assumption is not true. There's a possibility that your assumption is not true. If your assumption is not true, then you can act freely without fear. Say public speaking, Zafri, what Zafri is saying, the same problem I had personally, but very early stage of my career. I got rid of it very quickly during my foundation training. You see, when I joined our service, I was too much scared of public speaking. So much scared that while I was a professional in Gopalganj district, there was a program on 26th March. Independence Day. At that time in the collectorate, there were not many officers. Only three of my batchmates, assistant commissioners, and one DC and one ADC. That's all. And there was a seminar in the afternoon in the Nazrul Public Library of Gopalganj, where DC could not go, he was somewhere else. ADC was the chief guest. And I and the ADC took me with him. So I went along ADC, and after when we were seated in the front row in a sofa, an organizer came to me and told me that I have to speak. So I was so scared that immediately I rushed for toilet. I said that I had to go to toilet, and I came out and I didn't return. I was so scared of public speaking, you know. This is a true story. I was so scared. So why I was scared, there are other stories behind it. So I am not going into that detail. But I was scared of public speaking. So I recovered it from foundation training there, because we got our foundation training a little late. After 1 hour, 1 year in service, our first training was sergeant segment. So in sergeant segment training, we didn't get that much opportunity other than pulling chains and other things. Yes. So in foundation training, we got the opportunity. So one day, I liked one guest speaker very much. I thought that it was a wonderful class. But our colleagues were not impressed, and no one was offering a vote of thanks. At that time, vote of thanks was optional. Nowadays, it is compulsory. It is mandatory. But in our time, it was optional. So no one was volunteering. I felt so bad that this gentleman has worked so hard, delivered such a wonderful presentation, and no one is offering a vote of thanks. So I emotionally charged. I forgot my fear of public speaking and I got up. And I got up and I offered a vote of thanks.
And it started.
And it started. Everybody appreciated that it was a wonderful vote of thanks. So when all of my peers appreciated, so that was the breakthrough. That was the breakthrough, and I never stopped. I never stopped. Actually, I became the debate champion. Can you imagine? From being scared of public speaking and becoming a debate champion. So, you see, so in this way, one day you have to stand up and you have to do the thing you don't do. And only then you can change yourself. So in this way we can improve ourselves. So this is what we have discussed, is about personal matters. Okay. So it's a personal improvement. So far we have discussed. But the same principle applies to organizations. Organizations also develop a culture. Culture means way of doing things. And this is very difficult to change. You see, I'm a change maker. I always pursue change. I've been heading organizations since becoming additional secretary. Immediately after my PPMC, I was posted as Director General of the Anderson Center. So since then, it was in April 2009. Since then, I'm heading different organizations, chief executive. So, as chief executive, I always pursue change, doing things differently. So, changing an organizational culture is equally different. Is equally different. Like Bizan is struggling to move from rise to great, changing organizational culture is equally very different. Governmental system is it's an organization. Government is comprised of organizations. Say finance ministry behaves in certain way. MOPA behaves in certain way. Organizational. And breaking the way they behave is very difficult. So if you want to bring change, then you have to understand the problem, you have to analyze the problems. Why people are behaving this way? What they are scared of? Well, Habib was telling that he was trying to do things quickly, and people and his colleagues raised objections. So why you were doing this thing so quick? Do it slowly. That's the organizational culture. Don't give decision at one go. Make inquiry. This is organizational culture. Or send it for. So while I was secretary of banking division, whenever an issue used to forward it to ministry for clarification, ministry will never give clarification. They will send it to law ministry. They will send it to finance division for opinion. They will send to. Regulation wing of MOPA for opinion. So in this way, they will take 1 year. And after that, they will give a decision. But these opinions are totally unnecessary. What has to be done is clearly mentioned in the rules. There is law, there is rules, vidhi, providhi, everything is there. And there's no ambiguity. Even then, they are referring it to finance division or law ministry for opinion. So this is organizational culture, that we don't give our opinion directly. We will seek opinion from finance division and law ministry first, then we will issue our verdict. So breaking this culture is difficult because people have become habituated with it. And also there's a tendency of risk aversion. that people think that if I seek a verdict directly, so blame will be on me if I am wrong. So they want to shift responsibility. So this way, in order to make changes in organizational culture, we have to apply the same principles. Okay, so that's my presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for giving me the opportunity to thank you. Our class is very nice, but I know, sir, before this, I have worked in architecture, geography, banking, education, and I didn't know you before. I found that in that organization, people are very much scared of I work in my village, in a authority in another organization, but when I come to a ministry, I found that this is the situation. So, take ourselves some distance. But later on, we found that his action in the ministry is very much positive, and positive for making sense. I found that. And he told about the change in one ministry also when I was there, and here I found that there is a change. We are part of we don't want to change anything, because according to science, you know that every particle don't want to change this position, and we are also part of that. But we have to try this. We have to give very good change. We found that we are in a position that there is no change. So and we now today found that sir is take up the problem and give a solution which will be help us in our in my life. I think that it will help. I don't know, my delivery is very much bad, I think so, but I want that it will be better later.
Savar has done well in hacking me. Actually, in order to do better, you see, you need a little preparation.
Yes.
You need a little preparation. She was not prepared because she didn't know that she would have to do it. If she knew, she would have done some groundwork and she would have delivered better. And this is applicable to everything. You need to prepare yourself. You need to prepare yourself. And we fail to impress, or we fail to deliver because of lack of preparation. We don't prepare ourselves in most cases. In most cases, one gentleman was telling me, that gentleman was telling me that in one foreign international negotiation, Bangladesh team performed so poorly against India. So, Bangladeshi joint secretaries could not talk to Indian deputy secretaries, could not come to that. It's because of lack of preparation. Because there are many factors. We have nominated at the last moment. You know, in the ministries, officers don't know who is going to going to be the part of negotiating team. They get it at the last moment, and they have so many other things to do, and they are neglectful in preparing, and they go into negotiation without any preparations, without knowing. Not only international negotiation, but also going to meetings, interministerial meetings. As a secretary, I have found many officers attending my meeting, interministerial meetings. When I asked, he or she could not say anything, could not say anything. So why you don't know? Mr. Savar, I didn't know that I have come to the meeting. Only this morning I have been told half an hour ago that I have to come to the meeting, so I didn't have any time to prepare myself. So then sometimes, even if you get time, you don't take it. So we don't pick. And because of this lack of preparation, we suffer from lack of confidence. Lack of confidence, you have to can't pass. Preparation is the key. So you have to prepare. You have to understand your problem. Say, Shamima's case. Shamima is thinking that distance is her problem. So, as she can't reduce the distance, so she thinks that she is helpless. She can't do anything about it. She will become later. This is her fate of the community. But this is not the case. Distance is not the problem. Problem is her lifestyle. So, in order to understand, in order to solve the problems, you have to understand the problem. What is the problem? If you understand your problem properly, then you can come up with appropriate interventions, and then you will be able to perform better. Okay, so thank you very much.